Hey there, folks, and welcome back to Guilds and Goblins, the What If World show, where your questions and ideas combine with our totally random dice rolls to make off-the-cuff adventures. I'm ZZ Jamaloo, your host, joined as always by my friend Scully the Squid.
My Guild and Goblins character is named Skull and Bones. They're a shape-changing skeleton trickster. And I'm here with my friend Lola the Rabbit.
But in the game, I play Lolandra, a werebunny and nature mage who can command plants or ask them to do things nicely. Then finally, there's my friend, Zach. My character is named Zachamedes, a goblin egg chanter who casts powerful magical spells out of eggs. I'm not sure why, but it's fun. We've just got time for a quick recap of last week's adventures.
But if you want to check out all the past Guilds and Goblins episodes, we'll link them in the show notes.
Yeah, and if you want a taste of the Guilds and Goblins rules, they're being shared and playtested by our patrons on Patreon. That's patreon.com/whatifworld. Okay, team, last week you got back to Tinkertown and met with the Master Tinker. She finally had all the ingredients necessary to break the curse on the Trumpet of Travel.
Yeah, only it wasn't gonna be that simple.
That's right, we had to go inside the Trumpet of Travel and free all the people ourselves. Except it didn't seem like the people wanted to be freed.
What they really wanted was to use their guitar magic to put us to sleep and throw us in jail.
Yellow Landra and I got stuck in jail, but Skullin stayed behind to try to free us.
Only I lost track of them as soon as I got to the crazy town these people had set up inside the Trumpet of Travel.
And that's where we start our story. Zachamedes and Lolandra, you finally come to.
I reach for my glow egg to check out my surroundings.
You quickly realize you've been relieved of everything but your clothes. But the first thing you really notice is the smell of pickles.
Nice, I love pickles, especially a good pickled carrot.
Well, these are only pickled cucumbers.
Aw, shucks.
And you see you're in a dark pickle cellar. The only light in the room is filtering down through the cracks in the wooden floor above you. You hear footsteps and distant conversation, but it all sounds a little muffled.
Can I roll learn to try to listen better?
Go ahead, Zachamedes.
That's an 18 plus 3 makes 21!
With a roll that good, you realize a few things. You and Lolandra are each stuck in your own extra-thick glass pickle jar with a screw-on metal top that is perforated with just enough air holes to keep you breathing. But you twitch your overlarge goblin ears toward those air holes, and you hear a little bit of the conversation above.
It was two of those kids who were supposed to be on guard during the Truce Day parade. Guess they really messed that up.
Well, what are we supposed to do with them?
We'll have to wait to hear from Fox and Wolf.
But those two never agree on anything.
Shh. Do you want them to hear you?
Oh, I forget what big ears they have.
Then the pair quiet down, except for the clumping of their hooves.
Hey, can Zachamedes tell me what he heard?
Yeah, you two are really close together. It's just hard to hear what's going on upstairs.
So did I recognize either of their voices?
Not as such, but you can gather that they're probably from the Pickle Pig Guild.
Oh, and since I'm part woodland creature, have I heard of this fox and wolf?
Not necessarily, but roll me a learn check. Oh, that rolled off the table. That's a 5. Well, where bunny or not, your guild tended to steer clear of the foxes and the wolves. So all you heard were ghost stories, and you're grown up enough to figure they probably weren't true.
Well, pickles are just another form of cucumber. I'm gonna try to reach out to these jars with my nature magic.
Okay, well, your nature magic can't control everything in nature. So what are you trying to do?
I want to see if I can get some pickle jars to, like, roll over and crash into my jar so it, like, cracks the glass.
So you're gonna roll wonder, but this will be a hard roll.
Oh, so I'll roll 2 and take the lowest. Ah, a 12 and a 2.
It's hard to reach out through the pickles in their briny jars, but you manage to get one to wiggle just enough that it rolls off a shelf and bounces off your jar with a clatter and a crash.
What was that? I think our prisoners are trying to escape.
Oh, we're in so much trouble.
Yeah, I hope Skullin can find us real quick. Speaking of which, Skullin, give me a learn check to see if you can track your friends down.
Ooh, a 12!
It's just barely enough, it takes you a while. But you're sure you found the right tracks, leading up to a little pickle shop with a couple of burly pickle pig guards. Or merchants. You even hear them talking about their prisoners.
We're pickle makers, not prison guards.
Yeah, I don't mind, I kinda like being a guard.
As one gestures with a cloven thumb toward the door to their cellar.
I get to feel like I'm making a difference, and when it's quiet, I can read a little. Or at least I could if I didn't have to keep making pickles.
You like being a guard? Oh, don't worry, I won't tell the other pickle pigs.
Okay, if I send my hand down there, can it get them loose?
Your hand can only see what you can see, so you'll be blind unless you send your head down too.
Are there any barrels or something in an alley, since this is like an old west town?
Sure, there are barrels. Pickle barrels, in fact.
Great. I want to hide my body behind a pickle barrel, then pluck off my head and attach it to the wrist of one of my hands.
Do you want to bring anything else with you?
Can I?
You could probably fit something small inside your skeleton head.
I love being a skeleton. Yeah, I'll grab Zachymedes' egg and hide it in there, then send it sneaking like a headhand spider into the pickle shop.
Ooh, that's good. I'll make this an easy dare roll to sneak by them.
So I get 2d20, I take the best.
The best of the two, exactly.
That's a 4 and a 17!
Your head manages to sneak by on its little finger legs and crack the cellar door open just enough to skitter down. Just as you hear Lolandra shattering the pickle jar.
Oh, you couldn't have made me a minute early.
What fun would that be? You each have time for one action before the pickle pigs get down to the cellar. Well, do I sense Skullin arriving since he's got my egg? Sure, yeah, you sense him right at the top of the stairs. Then I shout out to Skullin, crack the egg in the doorway!
It's a fire shield, won't that be dangerous?
It's protective magic, it doesn't set things on fire. It's just extra effective against heat and cold.
So I crack it open, and then I run down to them.
Lolandra, it's your turn. I'm gonna try to rock back and forth and knock my jar over. Alright, well, it won't break it unless you roll really high. 15 plus 1, 16? You manage to knock it down, and there's just a little crack on the outside. Then I call out to Skull and Bones. It's about time, buddy! Okay, well, the pigs don't know that the fire is harmless, so they're trying to put it out with pickle water.
I'm gonna get fired from guard duty.
Oh, but they each roll a 5. My fire shield glows green like a pickle and holds strong. Zachymedes, since you didn't use the egg, you feel the fire shield will fail this round. With the green light glowing, can I see well enough to find where they stashed our stuff? I'll let you roll learn for that. 15 plus 4, 19. By the flicker of the green pickle light, you see two packs in the corner of the cellar, overflowing with all the stuff you used to carry. I pointed out to Skullin. Skullin, if you can get the Everthorn to me, I think I've got a plan.
Do I have to roll anything to find it?
No, you know what it looks like, but it'll take your whole turn to get it to Lolandra.
I scramble over to the pack as fast as my little finger legs will carry me. Then I grab her Everthorn earring and push it through the hole at the top of her jar.
I want to turn it into my thorn whip and see if I can use it to unscrew my jar. Roll dare. 5 plus 1. That's not gonna do it. I'm gonna roll to see if either of the pickle pigs run to warn the town. Oh, you got lucky. With a 9, they're a little too panicked and inexperienced to think to run for help, so they keep pouring pickle water on your shield until it finally evaporates in a vinegary mist. I want to use my thorn whip, but this time I want to try to open Zachymedes' jar.
Whoa, if I put my hand at the end of the thorn whip, can I give it a better grip?
Yeah, that'll make it an easy roll, plus Lola's dare. 13. Zachymedes, your jar top spins off with a twist of the thorn whip. You can either climb up the whip carefully as your turn, or you can scramble up quickly, but you'll take one hurt from the pokey thorns.
Oh, this could be an emergency, so I'm gonna scramble quickly.
You take one hurt. Now take your turn.
Can I get my pack, grab an egg, and throw it at the pickle pigs?
Just barely. They're already down the steps by the time you reach your pack.
Get back in your cage or you'll be sorry.
But you turn and throw your egg their way.
Uh-oh.
It's an egg tangle egg, so I guess I'll roll wonder. 13 plus 1, 14.
Nice. That's what they'll each have to roll in order to escape. A 5 and a 15. So one escapes, but the other is stuck tight, and their turns are over.
I want my head to roll into the shadow so they don't see me, but my hands will stay at the end of Lolandra's Everthorn.
Oh, thanks. Can I grab the other pickle guard and throw them in Zach's empty jaw? Well, they're big and heavy, but maybe Skullin can make it less hard. Skullin, how will your hand help?
I'll tickle the pickle pig.
Perfect. Lolandra, just make a straight dare roll. 10 plus 4, 14!
Stop! No fair! I'm half tickle pig, and thus extremely susceptible to tickles!
Wow, lucky guess.
On my turn, can I just focus on my spell so the other pig can't wiggle out?
Sure, since both guards are stuck, we'll call this challenge over as they warily watch you.
You two are in big trouble when Fox and Wolf get here. Yeah, like Fox and Wolf will even know what to do. They don't need to know that our leaders aren't getting along right now, and all the guilds are divided more than ever.
Is that why you captured us, even though we're trying to help you get out of the trumpet?
Really? You know the way out? Why didn't the bee scouts say so?
Because guitar bees weren't meant to be scouts, and pickle pigs weren't meant to be guards.
I could be a great guard if Wolf would just train me.
Hey, while they're arguing, can I get myself out of the pickle jar? Sure, you're out. All right, buddies, I say to the gods, we really want to help you get out, and fast, but no one's listening to us here.
They'll only listen to the leaders,
says the pickle pig who's still leg-tangled by Zach.
And they won't listen to anything you say, unless you can out-fox the fox and out-wolf the wolf.
If we let you go, will you help us? We've only got a few hours until the portal out of here closes forever.
I'll let you and Lolandra each make a roll and add Zach's wonder to see if you convince the guards.
Oh, I only rolled a 4 on the d20, but I got a 4 on wonder, so Lola, if you can roll better, I rolled a 7, but plus 4, that makes 11.
It's just barely enough. The two pickle pigs nod to each other, then to you. Now, Scullin, I need you to roll a d20.
What for?
You'll see.
14?
It's hard for you to sense anything when your head is away from your body, but you do suddenly detect a faint tickle, like long whiskers and warm breath sniffing at your bones as they lie back in the alley.
Oh, no. Could my bones retrace their steps out of town?
Yeah, but once they left, you wouldn't be able to control them until you saw them again.
That's fine, I've got a plan. My head speaks to everyone in the basement as I roll dramatically out of the shadows. Welcome to the team, Pickle Pigs, I say. Now we gotta get out of here fast.
What the?
Then I make my headless skeleton body spring up in the alley and start running out of town.
You all hear a howl from just outside the pickle shop, and then you hear 4 huge paws thundering away. And that's where we'll pause our adventure. I hope you've all enjoyed this installment of Guilds and Goblins, answering questions from Maggie, Julia, and Ruby. Of course, we'll see more of Fox and Wolf next week when we continue our adventure.
And add on more of your what-if questions.
Folks at home, if you really want to help out Guilds and Goblins and What If World, check us out at patreon.com/whatifworld.
Or just subscribe to us and leave a rating and review on Apple Podcasts or wherever you listen.
Excuse me, Fred the Dog here to shout out the Englehart family. There's Jeremiah, age 9, who loves video games and thought I made a very funny president.
Then there's Lydia, age 11. She loves how Arati and how I answer questions by singing them, even when Mr. Eric tells me not to.
A good thing Mr. Eric isn't here.
Lydia also loves animals.
That was really loud, Arati. See you next time.
Goodbye.
He's still going. Then there's Malachi, age 3. Malachi loves Buzz Lightyear and doing impressions of me, JF Cat.
And Mr. Eric here, coming to say hello to Owen. He's 5 years old and he's thrilled to join the What If World community. He loves, loves, loves all things dinosaurs and has a 2-year-old brother named Eli.
Finally, there's Tobin, age 11, who lives in Rochester, New York. He likes magic, drawing, and singing. And he has a little brother named Asher.
What If World is created by Eric O'Keefe and Karen O'Keefe. And we'd also like to thank Craig Martinson for our theme song, our helper Miss Lynn, and all you adventurers at home, who know that even when you're trying your best, not everyone's gonna see you as a hero. And that's okay. Until we adventure again, keep wondering.